Scots Parliament, it's nice to see so many of you at the end of a very large and successful campaign. The two members immediately involved are Jackson from Stirling, covering Dunblane, and myself from Oval, covering that end of the constituency. But of course, all the regional members of the Scots Parliament have a right to be involved as well. They represent you too. And there are committees going on in the Scots Parliament at 12:30. But normally, I think members would.
The letter that I received a copy of from that went to Stirling Council, telling them that in fact there is to be a public inquiry,
Before I go to Anne, let me just summarise my own position. Most of you were at the very large meeting in the Bridge of Allen. You've seen, I think, the quite significantly long letter I wrote to the Minister of Communities. And therefore I want to congratulate all of you on winning the first battle. You haven't won the war yet, but you've won the first battle, and you've done so by being organised in a remarkably short period of time. You've run a quite remarkable campaign to the number of individual letters to the Minister, which is the telling point, plus a petition which is now up to about 1,700, I think, isn't it?
1793.
That is really quite a remarkable achievement in such a small period of time. The Parliament, when it was set up, said it would always work in partnership with the people. But the people have to organise and use the process as well, and you've done that absolutely splendidly, so congratulations to you on that. I have seen my Parliament, when it was set up, said it would always work in partnership with the people. But the people have to organise and use the process as well, and you've done that absolutely splendidly, so congratulations to you on that. I have seen Margaret Kern, I've seen Stirling Council. I'm therefore very pleased, as Sylvia is, that it will go to public inquiry. My own position remains the same, that I objected on three grounds. The first was the ground of principle, crudely, that green belts should stay green and that communities should not coalesce. Secondly, in terms of process, a matter of such matter. But the people have to organise and use the process as well, and you've done that absolutely splendidly, so congratulations to you on that. I have seen Margaret Kern, I've seen Stirling Council. I'm therefore very pleased, as Sylvia is, that it will go to public inquiry. My own position remains the same, that I objected on three grounds. The first was the ground of principle, crudely, that green belts should stay green and that communities should not coalesce. Secondly, in terms of process, a matter of such magnitude, in my view, was not given sufficient consideration by Stirling Council. And thirdly, in terms of national interest, the site is a quite unique site in terms of the transition from central Scotland into rural Perthshire. It frames Stirling coming from the north. It's a site that's been part of Scots' environment and history for thousands of years. It's important nationally. And also in terms of national importance, what Sylvia touched on, Section 75, which I don't think gives any of the assurances that the community really wanted, and my fears were the fears of everybody, I think, in this room, that out of a golf course attached to a hotel would ultimately come executive housing, and would come timeshares, and that marvellous piece of greenery in the middle of Scotland would disappear. I think